الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. حبت في الله, the question was asked, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brother, I am a Muslim from Indonesia. How to increase Iman? Thank you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us all and bless us all with علم النافع ورزق طيب وعمل متقبل. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the path of Iman clear for us all. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and protect us from rejecting Iman and protect us from kufr, shirk, wa nifaq. Ameen, ya rabbil alameen. So first and foremost, I want to say one thing is, walillahi alhamd, you're in Indonesia. I know it's a big country and a series of islands. But there are a lot of mashayikh of Ahl Sunnah there and a lot of Tulab al-Ilm. And I know personally because I've been to Indonesia, and I know personally because I've had studied with one Indonesian sheikh when I lived in Medina. He used to be one of our teachers for some of the subjects we studied. And I know because when I traveled with some of the Tulab al-Ilm that were some of the big, what we say, the Kibar al-Tulab, with Sheikh Ibrahim Raheli at the time, especially from Indonesia, some of them who finished their PhDs and were doctor and became mashayikh in and of themselves. So there is a lot of durus. And I also know that many ulama from Yemen always go to Indonesia for daurat and to teach. And I also know personally that many mashayikh from Medina also go, like Sheikh Abdurrazak al-Badr, and also Sheikh, I believe Sheikh Ibrahim Raheli, and I believe perhaps maybe Sheikh, many other mashayikh definitely go there from Saudi and from around the world, but I'm talking about mainly mashayikh, Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. And so what I would say first and foremost, as far aside from trying to benefit locally as much as possible, is first to increase your Iman, as the ulama, they mentioned. For one, reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من تعلم القرآن من خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best of you are those who learn the Quran and teach it. So if you want to become the best, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the people, then learn the Quran. And you can learn the Quran without doubt there in Indonesia, as you can in any Muslim country. And in fact, in most non-Muslim countries, there are people to teach you Quran. But especially in a place like Indonesia, which is in fact is the biggest in number of Muslims, Muslim-populated country, even though we know all the other things that go on in Indonesia. Wallahu musta'an. So I will say, get on the Quran. Learn and do that to soften the heart. Secondly, is also reading the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reading the Sirah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reading Ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and seeking knowledge is one of the ways that increases your Iman. Because if you seek knowledge and you seek it, striving to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means you are embarking on the path of Jannah. And there is no way that getting on the path of Jannah could be without increasing your Iman. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, من سلك طريقا يلتمسه به علما سهل الله له طريقا الى الجنه. Whoever traverses the path of knowledge, Allah will make easy for him the path to paradise. So making your intention purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and learning more about your deen and sitting in the halaqat, and this will bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closer to Jannah. And the characteristics of Ahl Jannah wa Ahl Fiqh wa Ahl Al-Ilm. And likewise, another hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which emphasizes the importance of knowledge, is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, "Man yuridallahu bihi khayran yafaqahu fi din." Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives him fiqh fi din. So, a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a person is He gives him fiqh, some understanding of the religion. So, you and I want to strive to be of those people. So we need to gain some fiqh fi deen. And we can only gain fiqh fi deen by having an open heart, sitting at the feet of the scholars or with the tulab al-ilm, and benefiting and increasing our knowledge and lifting the jahil from ourselves, lifting the ignorance from ourselves and going forward. And as Sheikh Muhammad rahimahullah ta'ala said, اعلم رحمك الله إنه يجب علينا تعلم أربع مسائل الأولى العلم وهو معرفة الله ومعرفة النبي ومعرفة دين الإسلام بيدلة الثانية العمل به الثالث الدعوة إليه الرابع الصبر على أذى فيه والدليل قوله تعالى إلى وحديث وسورة العصر. طيب, one of the great imams in more contemporary times, he said, اعلم رحمك الله, he said, no, that very, and may Allah have mercy upon you. So here he is showing, he's making dua for you, trying to encourage your open your heart to listening to the beauty that he has to say. And this is going to help your iman. And this is going to help you and realize the importance of knowledge. He said, "I'lam rahimakallah, innahu yajibu alayna ta'allam arba'a masail." He said, "Verily, it's an obligation upon us to know four things." He said, "The first thing is knowledge." And then he described what he means by knowledge. He said, "It's knowing Allah and it's knowing His Prophet and it's knowing Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and it's knowing the religion of Islam with its textual proof." Again, that's showing us the importance of ilm, knowledge, learning more about your deen. And this will strengthen your iman. And then he said, Athani, he said, the second thing is to practice that knowledge. This is where a lot of us get caught up, where it's very difficult for us because we're not practicing like we should. And so, practicing that knowledge that you gain, if it's knowledge about Salat, if it's knowledge about Zakat, if it's knowledge about something of fiqh or something of creed, i'tiqad, whatever, or the importance of manners, practicing that, implementing that in your daily lives and affairs. And then he mentioned, so practicing, then he said sharing that knowledge. So share that knowledge with your family, with your friends, your co-workers, your schoolmates, whatever the case may be. Share the knowledge that you're practicing and that you're learning. And then he said, be patient on that because it's a difficult path, which is the path of the Anbiya. It's the menhaj, it's the methodology of the prophets, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam, who took that steep path, the path of knowledge. And it's the path of Iman. It's the path of Iman. So also learning about Tawheed, learning, it's all about ilm. It's about learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, learning the arkan al-Iman, learning the arkan al-Islam, you know, the pillars of Islam, the pillars of Iman, all of these things, and putting that into practice. And this is going to strengthen your iman. It's going to strengthen your faith. Likewise, along with that, is that, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that ma min shayin athqalu fi mizan al-mu'min yawm al-qiyamah min husn al-khulq wa inna Allah yubghidu al-fashil bidi. There isn't a thing that weighs heavier on the scale of the believer than good manners, and verily Allah hates wicked and sinful speech. So watch your tongue, try to stay away from sin, have good manners. Good manners, good to your parents, good to your neighbors, good to your friends, good to everyone. Share Islamic knowledge through your actions. And in fact, your country Indonesia, from what we know about the history, is that it became, you know, the people, the Hadarim, the people from Hadramaut in the south of Yemen, a lot of them used to do business there, used to do, you know, were tujar, and they came. And that's why you, as you know better than I do, there are Yemenis there that are Indonesian. I mean, they're Arab in their bloodline, but they are Indonesian by nationality and speech and language and probably even culture. So, a lot of the point is through good manners. Through good manners, whole countries can change to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leave kufr and shirk. Unlike those other people who, the extremists, who say that it has to be by the sword. Because we see a lot of the Muslim world, a lot of Muslims, and da'wah was effective by manners and business and things like this, by sharing the Islamic knowledge through the tongue and through action. So it's very important, because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma min shay'in athqalu fi mizan al-mu'min yawm al-qiyamah min husn al-khulq." He said there isn't a thing that weighs heavier on the scale of the believer than good manners. Also showing us what? That the husn al-khulq, or righteous manners and conducts, weighs heavy on your scale. So you're going to get rewarded in the hereafter. You're going to find fruits and benefits of it in this life. Likewise, it is a sifat of Ahli Iman, because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ma min shayin athqalu fi mizan al-mu'min." He said there isn't a thing that weighs heavier than the scale on the mu'min, of the believer, It doesn't, there's nothing that weighs heavier on that scale than husn al-khulq, okay, and the righteous khulq. And the ulama also mentioned with regards to good manners that part of that, you know, these good manners have to do with the haq of different people, okay, how you treat other people, whether that be non-Muslim, Muslim, mothers, fathers, you know, all, everyone has different haqq. They have different rights, your neighbors, everything. And likewise, this is inclusive, as the ulama mentioned, and Ibn Uthaymeen expounds upon this greatly in his Sharh Bulugh al-Maram, and also Ibn Baz as well, rahimahullah jami'an, that this husn al-khulq also includes the adab ma'Allah, the manners that you have with Allah. And what is the haq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on a donkey with Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala an. Qal, ya Mu'adh, tadri ma haq Allah li badi, wa ma haq li badi Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala an, who he sent to Yemen. He said, ya Mu'adh, do you know the right of Allah over his servants and the right of the servants over Allah? So this is the haq of Allah. So this has to do with the husn al-khulq, with the good manners, which is going to increase your iman and give you the sifat of ahl iman. He said, Allah wa Rasulullah alam. He said, Allah and his messenger know best. I don't know what the right, you know, he didn't know. He wanted to know what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. What is the right of Allah upon his servant? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, haq al-ali ibadi in ya'buduhu wa la yushriku bi shayn, wa haq al-ibadi Allah in la yu'adhiba man la yushriku bi shayn. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the right of Allah upon his servant is that he worships him and him alone. And the right of the servant upon Allah is that he doesn't punish him if he worships him and him alone. So look at that. All of that is going to help your iman. So those are practical steps. Likewise, just increasing your prayer, increasing your dua, learning supplications, subhanAllah, ilm. Ilm is the assas of everything. You need ilm to pray properly. You need ilm to make tahara properly. You need ilm to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Learn dua, prophetic dua. Listen to this dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We did it on this YouTube platform, and I still implement this daily. I try to say this dua, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because it's so important. It's about your relationship with your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. The dua is Allahumma inni as'alaka hubbuk wa hubba man yuhibbu wa hubba li kulli amalin ballaghni hubbuk. The dua is, O Allah, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika, Allahumma inni as'alaka hubbuk. O Allah, I ask you for your love and to love that which you love. And to love those who you love. Allahumma inni as'alaka hubbuk wa hubba man yuhibbuk, and love for those you love, wa hubba li kulli amalin ballaghni hubbuk, and love for every deed that will gain me your love. This is very profound and very powerful, and you need to have it so that way it's just a reminder. And you're supplicating, asking your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala to gain his love and to love what will help you to gain his love. You're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love, to put love in your heart so that you will worship him better and come closer to him. And that means iman. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.